Look, it's great to have a chance to talk to you about FeralScan. It's been work in development for many years, and we're very keen to hear from people that are using this particular resource as to how we can improve it for the next few years to come. I'm based in Orange in central New South Wales, work for DPI, and really have spent a number of years working with landholder groups and community groups around Australia using the FeralScan and FoxScan resource. And, it's an amazing free resource, which we want to try and promote people to utilise. I need to acknowledge that the Centre for Invasive Species Solutions, Australian Wool Innovation, and a number of government departments have been involved in the design, development, and adoption of FeralScan over the years. In essence, FeralScan and FoxScan are part of a web-based platform consisting of a website, a database of public records, and a dedicated purpose-built phone app. And I'll show you these resources over the next 10 minutes. The FeralScan platform can be used by anyone around Australia at any stage to record information about pests. Regardless of what they are, today we're focusing on foxes, and I'll show you fox components shortly. To find this resource, go to feralscan.org.au or an equivalent address for foxes. And the mobile app is a free resource. It's a public good thing, so it's always going to be free. And we're constantly making iterations and improvements to it based on feedback from people that are using it. So if you have recommendations, please let us know your thoughts. The main objectives of FeralScan, and this applies to foxes, is to help people provide a very user-friendly, easy method for recording observations and problems around foxes in their local area. Help people document their control activities. Now, in some circumstances, people do so to comply with their legal obligations around fox control. There's certainly benefits from documenting control activities for collaborating with organisations or other landholders in your area. And other people use FoxScan to record information about control as a requirement for seeking and obtaining assistance. We also want to provide an interactive map for records, which we do so securely, and provide people with a sort of range of different tools in which they can view information about foxes and fox control, and help groups and organisations to centralise important information. And this also includes monitoring camera photos and information about control programs where a lot of control sites are set up. But the bottom line is we want to try and help people to use the data that they're entering in whatever landscape to improve the way fox control programs are undertaken, try and strive for cost-effective activities. The information you can record includes sightings or evidence of foxes, the damage or impacts they're causing. There's a fox taking, actually that's probably a hare or a rabbit, but wildlife predation is one of the key things that people record, and control activities. Now, I'll also just point out that you can elect at any stage to record information like this and make it shareable with the public, or you can keep it private. But with respect to control actions, any information that anybody records is managed privately, discreetly, securely, so that if you're using any of the control methods that are available for foxes, we will manage your data super securely. You can record information directly via the website onto the map or via the phone app, and I'll just talk you through these two processes right now. If you are using the website, go to the FeralScan homepage and click on foxes. A dedicated page for foxes opens up, and everything you need to know about FoxScan is available from this homepage, and there's a number of links there. My contact details are always there, so I'm always here to provide assistance if anyone needs it. There's links to the app, there's instructions, and a whole lot of handy resources from this page. But up in the top right-hand corner is the link to the map. Click on that, and a map of Australia will open up. This is where you can actually view some records that have been entered by people that have allowed them to be visible to the public. But for recording an observation or some information, you click on the record data button up in the top left-hand corner. Then you zoom to your local area and zoom to the exact location where the fox or the fox incident took place. And when you click on the map, the coordinates for that location will display in one of the questions. And then it's a matter of using the questions on the left-hand side to best describe what you've seen at that location. Then submit your entry. Certainly, what we've seen in recent years is usage of the mobile app has increased enormously, and a lot more people are comfortable with using mobile apps to record things on the go. Some of the benefits of using the FeralScan app on your mobile device is obviously you can do it when you're traveling around in your local area. The location, time, and date is automatically estimated for you, and information you record is saved directly into your account. Now, this is a purpose-built product. So if there was an off-the-shelf product around when we started to design FeralScan, we probably would have looked at those, but there wasn't anything around. This has been purpose-built to meet people's needs, people that are working in all sorts of different organizations and locations for monitoring and controlling foxes. I'll just walk you through the app. So the first thing, the home screen would look like this. You click on foxes. Then you get to choose what sort of information you'd like to record. If you'd say, if you wanted to record a sighting, you click on sighting. The app, assuming the GPS is turned on in your mobile device, will give you your current location. Then it's a matter of answering the questions, add a photo if you wish, and submit your record. It's pretty straightforward and simple to use. The first time you use it might take you a minute or so, but we see that people become more familiar with it the faster they become at it. And I'm just going to, the second part of my presentation is just to show you a few examples of how people are using it in different locations. Now, this is not comprehensive by any means. It's just a few examples that'll help you sort of get a bit of a better understanding of how it's been utilized. So individual landholders, some record sightings, impacts, their control activities like 1080 baiting, ground shooting, monitoring cameras. A lot of individual landholders join private groups, which we manage for them within the software. And they gather and record information about foxes in their local area. And sometimes that information is then used to guide control, or, you know, that's the ideal situation. We also have situations where landholders will document all their 1080 baiting or all their individual control actions across their properties. So these are selected locations that aren't identifiable. So the information you're viewing today is rather sensitive, but I won't disclose their locations for privacy reasons. And we see, here's an example from today where a landholder on a rural property in New South Wales has been documenting their control and 1080 baiting usage to try and reduce the predation pressure from foxes on lambs across their property. Unfortunately, this is the reality of foxes in Australia. They prey on a lot of wildlife and prey on a lot of lambs. And this is a photo that was submitted today. And a lot of photos do get uploaded. It's horrible to see the impacts that foxes have in Australia, but this is why we are all committed to trying to improve the way foxes are managed to reduce the problems they're causing. We also see lots of photos from monitoring cameras, and we manage and handle these very carefully for people. Local government authorities, they do, in some places around Australia, receive reports from the community via FeralScan. Some groups reach out to landholders and residents and provide assistance. This is not always the case, so be careful to not to assume that this is the case in your area. Contact your local government authority to ask about what programs exist before assuming that they might be able to help. But certainly some local government groups do help, and it's wonderful to see that sort of practice taking place. And some groups, so some local government authorities record intensive control data, control program data themselves, especially when they're working in partnership with contractors. And the last point is we help local governments view the information that communities report and record. It's important that we make sure that the local government authorities understand what's happening in their local area. And one of the things we do is help them to view the information that the public enters. We do so securely. Of course, there are places around Australia where lots of the public do record information about foxes. Here is Sydney. I'm not sure if you can see Sydney underneath all of that, but there are reports that have been entered by the public over the years about the problems or about foxes and fox activity across that district. And so in these locations, local government groups sometimes try to help people with targeted control programs, or they try and run education programs, because foxes are very abundant across metropolitan areas of Australia. And it might surprise you that there are actually in Sydney and other metropolitan areas quite cleverly designed fox control programs in some locations, and this is feasible in some areas. And here is a location in Sydney. I won't show you the location exactly, but some very clever fox control being undertaken to protect threatened species and protect people that live there. Professional fox controllers, some record baiting, trapping, shooting, usually for an employer or a landholder group. Also at an undisclosed location in Western Australia, people are doing intensive control and intensive shooting programs, and they're using FeralScan to record that. And often it happens also that people doing this are also putting up plenty of signage and recording that information and recording what they're doing in terms of the animals that are being destroyed. And regional biosecurity groups, some groups record data. So a good example is the local land services in New South Wales or the recognised biosecurity groups in WA. Some groups record control data. They usually do so to collaborate with landholders and groups. They do document widespread control programs in some places. And really importantly is we try to help them connect to community members of the community that are recording information about foxes to help them support people. And here's a good example in New South Wales where landholders across this particular location record problems with foxes, and local authorities also support that through doing targeted intensive local scale control. One of my last slides, one of the key things that FeralScan does is try to help people connect with practical advice and resources. So if you use FeralScan to record information, we'll try and get you information that may be useful for your own circumstances and show you things that exist for doing small-scale or regional-scale control programs, including practical videos. What we can provide, we can attend workshops or events for you. We can run some online training for you or your group. We do provide instructions and ongoing assistance and support. That's really critical. Connect people to practical resources, as I said. We do also manage and set up private groups for a lot of people around the country. And we manage data and photos for people that use FeralScan. Most importantly is that we provide ongoing assistance to anyone that uses FeralScan. And if you have any questions or you'd like to ask me for assistance, I'm always going to be here. I'll leave it there. Thank you.